Right, good afternoon, folks. It's time for a new medium long play for the channel, and we're gonna be playing Valkyria Chronicles. Pretty good game. Let's put this in English and let's get started, shall we? So, it's a mix of World Wars, tanks, and anime. The best kind of game.
It was 1935 BC. Two powers controlled the continent. In the east, the sun rose over the autocratic East European Imperial Alliance, otherwise known as the Empire. In the west, a network of loosely allied democracies formed the Atlantic Federation. Both powers depended on a precious mineral, ragnite, for their survival, and its growing scarcity led to the inevitable war.
So the map is fairly similar to Europe.
The Atlantic Federation responded, and the Second European War was on. Vast military superiority struck hard, gaining ground in early victories and putting the Federation on the defensive. Emboldened by their progress and momentum, the Empire set their sights beyond the borders of the Federation. In neighboring Gallia, a peaceful principality along the sea, they found their next victim. Gallia had long maintained its neutrality in the tensions between the two superpowers. But the rich stores of ragnite under the Gallian soil proved too tempting for the Empire. It amassed troops along the eastern border and invaded with all the force of an avalanche. Prologue. Gallia to arms.
Alright, so it's basically, little storybook that we'll have to go through every little square. So a lot of animations, a lot of talking, but the game is pretty interesting. So not a lot of talking from me, which is pretty fine.
Outside the Gallian border town of Brule. Residents are leaving the town before the invasion, headed inland towards the capital.
Let me know if the audio's A-okay, by the way.
I haven't been down this road in years. It really hasn't changed very much. Guys, you're beautiful. Starting early this year, you're heading upstream, huh? How's the water?
Hands in the air, slowly. Haven't seen you around before. What's your name?
My name's Welkin, and you are?
The one with the gun. We're with the Brule Town Watch. I'm Alicia. Alicia Melchiot. So, I'm wondering what you've been writing in that little book you've got there. Imperial spies are in the area.
This book is nothing, really. I was just sketching the fish and, you know...
Yes. Oh, I know. And you know there's a war on, don't you? All right then, Mr. Artist. We'll talk about fish sketching down at the station. Take him away.
Take him away, boys.
Thanks, fish.
So we're just gonna breeze through these until we have actual missions.
Apologize, but I was just doing my job, you know. I saw you with the notebook and thought you were a spy. Again, I'm really sorry about that.
Thanks. Don't worry about it. I can see how I might have looked a little suspicious.
Wilkes has a real passion for observing nature. That's why he's studying it at the university, right?
Guilty as charged. I get so into it sometimes I forget where I am or that somebody might be watching me.
Gunfire! Everyone, keep your heads down!
Over there!
Come on!
Through training, anyway.
Well, they're probably just a small scouting team. We should be able to take them out.
Small scouting team throwing grenades. All right, our first mission. All right, let's do as they say. I had a game in 2015. So we got scouts. It's the tutorial mission, so it's pretty easy. I take it you played this game before?
Yep,
played this. Heard the fourth game that just came out a few months ago was pretty good as well.
Just stay calm and get it done.
Second one was okay, and the third was pretty bad, from what I remember, from what I heard.
I see three of them.
That's three too many. Stay sharp.
Yeah, it's a great game.
Listen a second. There's something I should explain.
There is one thing, though. You can kind of cheese all the missions with the scouts. So these are our command points. Basically, it's the number of times we can move a unit. We'll move our units. It's our action points, basically. Alright, so we have Welkin, Alicia, and Town Watchman. We're going to use Welkin for now. Well, thanks there, FP. Appreciate it, man. So, in the bottom there we have our move bar. We can move until it runs out. And when we attack an enemy, first off we can crouch behind bags, we'll have more cover. Go into aiming mode, and basically the circle is where we're gonna shoot. It's not just the crosshair, it's like pretty much anywhere in the circle. So we could miss if we aim for the head, but we only need two shots to the head to kill. So we're gonna give it a try here. Now, if we hadn't killed him, he would be able to retaliate. And since we're behind cover, you die there, soldier. Now, we could play Welkin again, but notice that his bar in the bottom right is, we're missing a quarter now, or a third of his movement points.
My turn, okay?
Now scouts can move a lot. So basically, the cover, we can't get crit either. Now they will shoot us if we're at we're near the range. And also, if the enemy moves into our range as well, we can shoot them, so... So let's aim for the head here and hope for the best. And there we go. That was an easy tutorial mission. Operation complete. Now it's gonna get a lot harder, of course.
I don't see any more of them.
We get a lovely A rank for that. Because we finished in one turn. Eat them.
So it's begun. I'll do whatever it takes to protect the people of this town. I'll do it. Even going to war, I'll do it.
Now we saw that in the intro.
What are those?
Magic missiles.
The lion's paw. It blooms white. Small, simple, and strong.
I want to be able to remember, once the war is over, that it wasn't all just people killing people. That that even in war, there was also new life.
War. War never changes.
On the 15th day of the third month of the year 1935, the Empire began its assault in earnest. A formal declaration of war was made upon Gallia. Though it was only a small front in a massive continental assault, what followed would prove that a tiny nation could best a military giant. These events would tell a story of tragedy hidden in the mists of time. A story of courage and of trust, of persecution and hate, and of love blooming even through the flames of war.
Can love bloom on the battlefield?
This is a record of this conflict, and of those who fought, lived, and died.
Title drop. Yeah, like I said, we're gonna have a lot of cutscenes, but... the strategy is pretty fun. Also, it's very anime. Very. Be ashamed if something happened to it.
Well, citizens, our enemy can't be far behind. I thank you for your help. Goodbye, and take care.
The packing coming along, Ys?
Almost done. I only need to take the everyday basics.
Well, the Empire's got to be close by. Let's hit the road by sundown.
Martha, look! Welks is here!
Oh! Welcome back, Welkies!
Story gets better once they hit the beach episode.
You're still calling me that? Martha, I'm 22 years old. And more important, you shouldn't be running around. Aren't you due any day now?
Ah, a light jaw won't hurt the little spud. I should know. I've already had four of them.
Hello there. Is Welkin in?
Hello, Alicia. What brings you here?
I just wanted to apologize. For before. Here. This is for you.
Really? These are for me?
I work at the bakery. Well, I did until the war started anyway. It's where I live, too.
She's a baker. She's a keeper, boys.
That's preserved bread, so it's pretty hard. Heat it up before you eat it, all right? I baked it myself, so the flavor's guaranteed. Best you ever had.
Thanks. Do you want to come in?
Slick moves there, Welkin.
Busy day of it, haven't you, Welkies? And what a lovely lady you are for all that adventuring. Good job, Welkies.
You know, like, 4 people died, right?
What? Wait, no, it's not like that. Alicia just saved my skin, that's all.
He's right, we just met. I'm not his girlfriend, just his hero. Although I'm really hoping to be his friend.
Ouch. Hate to hear that.
Oh, well, I'm sure you will. Be good to my whelkies here, won't you?
Okay, seriously, Martha, enough with the whelkies already.
That's a lovely portrait. Is that General Gunther?
Yep. It was taken before I was born. That's Dad.
That's Dad? You're a lucky guy.
Having a dad and all?
And who's that with him there?
My father, Tamer. He was an engineer. The General's tank was his creation.
Wait a minute. But I thought the General was your dad.
My birth parents died when I was a baby. The General was kind enough to take me in as his own after that.
Yeah. We're not related by blood, but she's definitely my little sister.
Sorry, was that question too personal?
No, I don't mind at all. I was blessed with 2 wonderful fathers.
This game is awfully progressive.
Yeah, I guess you were, huh?
Oh, is that really the time? I've got to get going. Why don't you see her off, Welks? I can take care of the rest of this on my own.
All right, I will. I'll be right back.
See you later, Isara. Safe travels.
Wow, look at this. Brule's really becoming a ghost town.
They've been leaving for a while. Just about everyone is evacuated by now. You can't blame them. Tensions are rising with the Empire. We'll survive. The town watch will guard and protect the home front. Everyone will come back someday. They'll come back when it's safe again, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, Welkin, I'm curious. Are you gonna join the army like your father?
I don't think that's for me. What I'd really like to do is be a teacher.
Draft dodger?
Huh. A teacher?
Yeah. Animals and insects, flowers and plants, they've always been my passion. I've learned a lot from nature. See, my dad, he protected this country as a general, but it's just that I want to give back in my own way. My own way. You know what I mean?
No.
I think I do. You're sure about it? Wow. That's deep. In your own way.
Ah! What was that?
That sound.
No, not the mill. I like how he's shooting these civilians running away. What a bastard.
Town watch together now. We've got to fend them off.
They must be at Mill Plaza. I'll help.
Thanks, Welkin. Now move out. Stay low.
That's fine. I never had a problem with English audio.
I'll explain the mission.
So, we gotta push them back. I don't think they have tanks in this one, so we should be fine.
Okay, let's begin. It's up to us to defend Brule. Target is the Imperials in Mill Plaza. Focus on taking down their captain. Breaking the chain of command should at least buy some time for the townspeople to get away.
All right, I got it. Let's all be careful out there.
Got a second? Listen close and I'll explain.
What happened to the other shitty anime game? Which one? Which one? Neptunia. No, that was a Patreon game.
Here we go.
Thank you, tutorial. I think we're good now. All right. So shoot for the head. Oh, on the last shot. This guy.
Yes.
Killed him.
My turn, okay?
Now, this guy's behind a, behind some sandbags, but we can throw a grenade. And that takes care of his defense.
My turn, okay?
And without the sandbags,
now.
He's dead. Shot, so I'll just put her there. Is this the game where a scout rush wins you every single mission? Yes. Yes, it is. So yeah, when the enemy attacks, you can always counter, which is nice. And sometimes the character will duck down and dodge all the shots.
go.
It's pretty embarrassing. Pretty embarrassing there, Welkin. To be honest, I should only use Alicia. The magical girls, about mission 12, I think.
Now.
Nice shooting. Alright, it's turn 2. He should die on the counter, so. Does the game only give you scouts? Well, it's the first mission. Then we'll have lancers and shock troopers and engineers.
My turn, okay?
Now, sometimes you'll have units that have a little medal on top of their unit, well, kind of like Alicia and Welkin. The Town Watchman doesn't have one. Now, if you take out that unit with a nice placed headshot, they will lose a command point. Yeah, Alicia is like really, really good. She's probably the best unit. And she's the first unit. But she gets overpowered through her skills more than anything else. So we're completely screwed.
Welkin, tank!
That's not good. We're not equipped to take out a tank.
Oh yeah, there's snipers as well.
I hate to say it, but we should probably pull out for now.
Welkin never pulls out.
get off this road and into the alley to the east. It's too narrow for a tank to follow. And try to stay behind cover while moving. One blast from that turret and it's over.
All right. Operation Survive. Yeah, the tank takes two command points to use. Alright, Welkin got out of there. Screw the rest.
Phew. Looks like we shook them. What are you doing from here?
If they're rolling in the tanks, there's not much the town watch can do. We'll try to buy time so everyone can get away. I'll dig in my heels at the main gate and do what I can to stall them.
Okay, I'll head back to my house and grab Isara and Martha, then come back.
Be careful out there, Welkin.
C rank, how embarrassing. Escape.
Isara, Martha, please be okay.
Damn, he is running fast. Tactical rule.
I will thank you to watch your tongue in this house. You have to leave now.
That's a big gun for such a little girl. Drop it.
Isara!
Huh? Hold it right there! Die!
Isara, are you okay?
I'm okay, thanks to you. But Martha, I think she's
Martha. Pregnant.
This isn't good. She's gone into labor. Moving her would be dangerous.
Right. Well, we can't just leave her here. What are we gonna do?
She ate the bread.
A lot of Imperials out there, Ys. It's only a matter of time before they take over the Mill Plaza.
Welks, listen. The barn out back.
What about it?
Our fathers have left us something. Something that might get us out of this mess.
What could it be? Oh. It's a military grade tank. You know. Especially what a civilian should have.
And it's one of a kind. Here it is, the Edelweiss.
Tamer built it especially for General Gunther.
Yeah, and it worked great, too. So it's just been parked here in the barn?
I wanted to make sure it would still operate, you know, in case of emergencies. I enrolled in a maintenance class given by the military. I wanted to be able to do what my father could do.
Oh, I mean, you never know.
That's great. But that's only a class, Isara.
It really didn't need much. Hardly any alterations at all. I just fitted it with a new turbine engine. It really improves on the power-to-weight ratio.
How could you afford that?
Its firepower and mobility are more than a match for recent models.
Well, assuming it does work. What's next?
All right. Welks, you took the armored vehicle course, didn't you?
Yeah. Back in high school. Once.
We'll bring Martha here. She'll be safe inside the tank, and we can move to a better location. Just leave the driving to me, okay? All you have to do is give the orders.
Oh, this foolproof plan? What can go wrong?
Isara, we ready to roll?
Engaging engine. The Edelweiss is ready for deployment.
Alicia could still be out there dodging bullets, buying time for people to evacuate. Here's the plan. We're gonna pick up Alicia and get out of town.
Yeah, that's true.
All right, Edelweiss. Move out!
Doesn't explain why they had military equipment, though. Maybe they're just cool with it, you know? Does the kid even have officer training? Well, he said he had a class. A class.
Here's the brief for this operation.
Alright, so we gotta protect the gate.
Alright, let's begin. We've got to stop them here. Casualties among the townspeople. The town watch will defend this gate so as many people as possible can get away. Got a second? Listen close and I'll explain.
Sure. Handbags and hand grenades? What? What is this? Okay, so slight tank. I think I can climb up the where do we sight an enemy? Oh my god. Oh, maybe I can snipe this guy. I cannot. So, but yeah, we don't really have anything we can do here. But we can take out that scout over there. Where is he?
Enemy unit spotted. Now.
That's the wrong one, but please. You had one job? There we go. Alright, see you later there, Umi. Scout over there, but I think I'll just go behind cover for now. There is a scout, like, over there. We don't have a grenade. I gotta wait for the tank to appear. That's pretty much all I can do. No, I should have put the watchman under undercover. I think you have two rounds and then the tank arrives.
turn, okay?
I think I can throw the grenade from here. Ah, damn, it's gonna hit the roof. Perfect. Roasted and toasted. A shot at this guy. That's not great, though. Get a better shot from above? Well, no, because he's under a sandbag. Though, on my next turn, I'll be able to chuck a grenade at him.
No.
Welkin has arrived. Finally, we get our tank.
Here we go.
The tank should be able to breach that wall. It may provide us with a shortcut, Lux.
All right, let's give it a shot. Hang in there, Alicia.
All right, so tanks are really good in this game. Really good. But they're very expensive when it comes to command points. Just like in every other game, shooting the back of a tank is the best way to go. Also, we have no direct shot, so we'll have to end our turn.
Entering combat.
So you want to hit the generator, that's where the real damage is.
Fire!
So basically, hit the radiator. It depends on a few things, to be honest.
Minor damage sustained.
Because once the tank gets upgraded, yeah, definitely a direct shot is a one-shot kill, especially against light tanks. Let's make sure we're not gonna miss our shot here.
Fire!
Kaboom.
Yes, we stopped it. Nice work, Ace.
Woohoo! Now you're my hero, Welkin.
The Imperials are running off for now. Looks like we bought some time, at least.
Welks! Welks! It's a boy! Martha had a boy!
She gave birth in Dad's tank?
It's oddly convenient.
Yes, and without complications. They're both perfectly healthy.
So she delivered the baby while driving the tank. She is quite talented.
Good. That's fantastic. Now let's stay sharp as we head out of town.
Getting paid. Yeah, I'm glad you can enjoy this FP. It's a pretty fun game.
2 hours after the first shots were fired, Bruel was under Imperial control. Though a mere skirmish by Empire standards, the raid on Bruel would mark Welkin Gunther's first taste of battle and begin his rise to a Galleon hero. I thought I would be ready for this. I knew war meant this might happen. It hurts. Seeing my town overrun like this, seeing all those people killed, it's just not right.
Damn you, war. Why you gotta ruin everything? Yeah, basically. Freeport.
We look at those birds and see how wild and free they are.
It's not the time, Welkin.
If anything threatens their home, they'll risk their lives to defend it. People are animals too. We do what we have to, when we have to. Animals are in a constant struggle to stay alive, but I've also seen them help each other, almost like they were cooperating in order to survive.
Cooperating?
That's why I'm so into studying natural science. That coexistence. I want to know how it works. If we could figure that out, mankind could put it to use for our own survival.
The cooperation.
That's why I want to be a teacher, so that I can pass that knowledge on to the children. I mean, even if we can't completely eliminate war, at least we might learn to live together as one people.
He's a globalist. Alex Jones, save us. She just stole the baby. What is wrong with you?
He's adorable.
Just like you said, even in war, new life happens all around us. Come here.
Smell the dead bodies.
That's your hometown.
Someday, we'll come back home again.
Yes. Someday soon. I know it.
Chapter 3, Vassal Urban Warfare. In March of 1935, the Empire began its invasion across Gallia's eastern border. Maximilian, commander of the Gallian
Front,
built his army around mobile armor. Ghirlandio and the other fortresses along the border fell to his tanks in quick succession. Bruel's fall in under 2 hours was typical of villages in the Empire's path, and the road to the capital bore a steady flow of refugees. Randgreese, Gallia's capital, a town secure and stable since ancient times. Within its walls stood the castle.
It's a nice wall.
And within its unicorn spire resided Cordelia, Gallia's princess. Supporting Gallia's policy of neutrality was a system of universal conscription. Under it, all schools required military training each year. In the event of a war, citizens were then drafted into the militia to defend their country. As the conflict with the East grew worse, both Welkin and Alicia found themselves no exceptions to that fate.
So these are my new digs. Oh, my uniform. I should get changed before reporting in. Better get ready now. Flares, binoculars, a compass, and a map. Everything you need for a nice hike. Or combat.
Welkin? Can I come in?
Sure, it's open.
Oh, you're already changed too. Let's see. Not bad, not bad. You look good, actually. So, how about me? Do I look all right in this? Convincing?
Yeah, that nice red ribbon is really good for combat.
Let's take a look. Yeah. You look fine. You wear it like a pro.
Really? You're not just saying that?
Of course not. You look tough. I like it.
Oh, good. I was worried it looked kind of silly.
No way. That plating on the back? It's like a coleopterid exoskeleton. Beetle-tastic.
Coleo what? And did you just say beetle? Welkin? What kind of girl wants to hear that she looks like a bug?
Huh? Not just any bug. A rhinoceros beetle, king of the insects. Who wouldn't want that?
Smooth.
Uh-huh. I guess I'll just try to take that as a very welcome sort of compliment.
Tell me about that scar. You've been wearing it since I met you.
Why does she wear the scarf?
It's part of my uniform from the bakery.
Is that right?
She takes it off. Will she die?
I don't want to forget the time I spent busting my buns baking.
That's a good pun. Good job, Alyssa.
I plan to keep wearing it until I can get back to manning the ovens again.
That's great. Once you do, I'll be first in line to get some of that bread.
Is that a promise? Well, I'll be sure to have plenty of it ready and waiting for you.
Absolutely. Hey, if you're ready, we should probably go see the captain now.
I don't think so. I think she still has it.
Galleon Militia enlistee Welkin Gunther, reporting for duty.
Ma'am, Galleon Militia enlistee Alicia Melchiot, also reporting for duty.
I'm Captain Eleanor Varrott, commander of this regiment. Gunther, you're promoted to lieutenant. You'll be leader of Squad 7 now.
Ma'am.
Enlistee Melchiot, you're promoted to sergeant. You'll be under the lieutenant's command. Understood?
Ma'am.
What do you know? It is you.
A guy for no battle experience. That's a pretty good promotion.
I had no idea that you'd enlisted.
Yep. Now that there's
Fabio
going on, I joined up. Pretty much all the officers and training boys are here just like you.
You know each other?
Yes, ma'am. We knew each other at university. Welkin was in science and I was in archaeology. And just look at us now. No archaeology or science. Looks like the two of us are studying war, I guess.
Looks that way. It's good to see you.
And you.
That'll be all for now. There's a strategy briefing later today. But you still have time. Time for you to catch up. You'll be spending a lot of time on the post and in Randbreeze. They'll be your new home. So get to know them. That'll be all. Report back in time for the briefing. Until then, you're dismissed.
Alright, so this is the HQ. We got a lot of stuff we can go through here. We can go check out the barracks. So these are our four units for now. We have our tank commander, we have our scout, our shock trooper, and we have our lancer. Each of them have different roles. But Alicia is going to be the one that we're going to be using the most. Well, if we wanted to cheese, we'll probably play it right, I think.
It's good to see you doing the rounds. Welcome. This is the command room. Use it to structure your squad. You'll have access to both drafted and volunteer recruits. Now that I think of it, Squad 7 is still short on soldiers, isn't it? I'll explain how this works. This is the master list. The recruits have all been assigned classes based on their talents. I should probably touch on the five classes, just so we're clear.
Yeah, five classes.
First off, you have the scouts. Just like the name suggests, they'll be your eyes. Their best asset is their mobility. They can go out, collect intel, then make it back safely. That, and a keen eye for enemies. A good scout can spot a man in tall grass from 100 yards. That comes at the price of firepower. Their job is spotting enemies, not taking them out. Next up, the shock trooper. They're the ones to break through enemy lines and clean up. They offer excellent offense and defense. As far as combat goes, they're as good as it gets. While they lack any specialized techniques, they also don't have any obvious shortcomings. Think of them as the least finicky unit in your squad, Lieutenant. After them, we have lancers, then anti-tank units. They're critical when facing armored targets.
Yeah, these guys are pretty good for tanks, but pretty bad for anything else.
This is pretty self-explanatory. In most cases, they're the only way to stop a tank. They're also well shielded from explosives, which conveniently includes tank mortars. Sadly, they're slow and weak to gunfire. Their limited ammo could also be called a drawback. Changing gears, we have the engineers. They handle supplies and perform combat support. They can restock other units' ammunition, treat the wounded, even repair tanks on site.
I remember when I was playing my first playthrough, I think I maxed out engineer at first, because it was so cheap.
Sandbags for cover, disarm mines, repair towers, you name it. Their actual combat skills are very low. Think of them as combat facilitators. Lastly, we have the snipers. They can shoot down targets from a considerable distance. You won't find better soldiers for marksmanship and range. They can hit targets I can barely see.
Yeah, snipers. A good sniper is really good.
Sniping rifles also come with scopes that work to augment a sniper's natural eyesight. Drawbacks include low mobility and defense. If the enemy gets them alone, they're done for. That should cover the basics. Go ahead and put a squad together now. There's room for 20, and you can swap units at any time.
Alright, so now we get to choose everything. Also, every character has their own perks and, well, inconveniences, disadvantages. So this guy is good in grassy fields, he's good with women, he's better when they're around. He's also claustrophobic. Got Ted. If he's near a tank, he loses health. If he's near men, he is also better, and if he's near women, he's also better. Oh, if I don't remember FP. You'll have to look it up. I know you unlock perks by using them. Or, no, by upgrading the class. This guy can only have 3 perks, though. Meadow Brand. Acimophobic. Being around Lancers. Make him lose HP, but he's... Let's go with Jan? Isn't Jan a... Where is Jan anyways? Also, I think when the units are next to people they enjoy, they get bonuses as well. Country bred, camaraderie, and bad back. So if he's crouched down behind sandbags, he'll lose some defense. He likes Alicia and Homer. We got Susie here. It's a good buddy. It's troopers. Not gonna go through all of them, I think. Well, I could. We got Cherry. She likes Rosie. And Rosie's gonna be our go-to shock trooper, so we're definitely gonna use her. Pollen allergy, good buddy. Metalhead, claustrophobic, and they all have their own voice actors and all that. It's pretty neat. So who are we gonna take? I remember Vice being pretty good. Take the Skies of Arcadia character.
The name's Vice Engelbart. Let's go kick this war in the teeth.
Lancer Killer.
The name's Jane Turner. I'll do anything if it means putting holes in imps.
I hate imps as well. I remember using Catherine a lot. There was another sniper as well that's really good. Well, let's get one.
Hello, I'm Catherine O'Hara. I look forward to joining you all.
Yeah, that's not good. Desert allergy. I think I'll take Claudia.
Hello, I'm Claudia Mann. I'll do my best to live up to your expectations.
Do we take Yoko? A little lifesaver? Well, we're gonna need scouts, that's for sure. Yeah, Frisia's fine because I don't think she has any disadvantages.
I'm Frisia York, handsome. I know you'll take real good care of me.
Susie.
My name is Susie Evans, sir. I realize I'm inexperienced, but I'll do all I can.
Still got 10 open slots. Panicky is like the worst one. No, there's one where they just drop their ammo. They get shot at or something like that. It's really bad.
Wordsworth, aye.
Like, she has nothing good. She has everything good. So, Nina, welcome to the party.
The name's Nina Strice, and I look forward to a good workout out there.
So, what do we have so far? We've got 4 scouts, 4 shock troopers, 2 lancers, 1 engineer. Okay, let's look at the lancers here. We don't need that many lancers, though. Scout hater.
Hector Calvi, sir.
Desert allergy, I'm not a fan. Metalhead and fatalist. Oh, sure.
I'm Ramsey Clement. Hey.
All right, let's get her.
Hey there, I'm Ika Thompson. I'll try my best. Sound good, Wilkin?
I guess. All right, Ted.
Thank you, hello. I'm Ted Ustinov, and I've got some great new material for you.
Duty, sir.
All right, I got 3 more. Like, when we're gonna do our missions, we're not gonna bring all 20, of course. But it's good to have a diverse group. Diversity is our strength, of course. Lancer.
My name is Rosina Selden. I'm in with you guys as of today.
You know Corin, reporting for duty. Joining you in Squad 7.
All right, the crew has been assembled.
Well, feel like you've struck a balance? Come back anytime you'd like to adjust your squad. As time passes, we'll have more recruits to choose from, so keep an eye on that list.
Yeah.
Oh, and all the recruits go through training together, so they're all ready for combat. They'll be at the same level as the rest of the team you've taken into the field. You can swap out members without the worry of losing the benefit of their experience.
So that's really good.
Trust in your own judgment and pick a team you know you can work well with. That should be enough to get you started. You can figure out the rest as you go.
Wow. Squad leader's a lot of responsibility. Come to think of it, Faldio's heading up Squad 1, isn't he? I wonder if he's off sorting through this stuff now, too. I better get a move on.
Alright, and now we have the training field. And this is where it gets interesting.
Welcome to your
your worst nightmare. I'm the guy who's gonna whip you lazy blobs into shape.
He's not as crazy as the guy in Fallout 2, but...
Still, I can't work miracles here. No amount of drilling beats real combat experience. I want you all to go out there, kick some imtail, and then show me what you learn. I will train that experience into something you can actually use. Level you bums up. But don't go trying to hog all the glory. A squad's a team, and we got no need for stars.
Stars.
Class and level up by class. Scout level 2. Scout level 3. You get it? When the scouts level up, that means each and every one of them goes up that level. You hear me, maggots? Any of you think he's better than the rest of the team, go home now! All right. Now I'll show you lowlights how this whole thing actually works. It ain't complicated. First, you go out there and fight. Then divvy up that experience here. Once the experience you cram into a soldier class clears a set amount, it'll level up. Picking which class to level up and when is your job as the squad leader. Now give it a go. Train all you want. I've got all day.
All right, so all our classes are level 1. If we want to level it up, we just bring it past the bar there. Notice that some classes are a lot easier to level up, like Engineer. Some classes take a lot more, like Shock Trooper and Sniper. So I think what we'll do for the first one is just get everyone at level 2. Now our sniper has accuracy boost, which is pretty nice, and our lancers have first aid boost, tank killer, anti-armor boost, and first aid boost. Now let's get our, do we get our scouts at level 3 or do we get our shock troopers at level 3? What do you guys think? I'll let you decide. How to scrap this adventure. Probably not sniper, because we only got one. But scout and shock trooper, that we have the most. No, not engineers. I've done that. I swear to God. You had one job, guys. One job. Also, you can get a class halfway in, but there's no real point.
You're better than this. Push those limits. Work, maggots. You're one level closer to human.
All right, so.
Got it. That's how training by class works. Now get out there and rack up some experience. Oh, and there's one more thing to add. Sometimes leveling up a unit class will unlock a hidden potential in them. You can think of potentials as the natural abilities your soldiers have inside them. Those abilities will form a big part of your strength in the field, so keep them in mind.
Yeah, Alicia, when she gets her full potential, she is pretty scary.
Sometimes, leveling up a class will earn you clearance for a new order. Here, as long as we're talking about it, I'll teach you a classic, a real golden oldie. Orders are special commands you can give out as the squad leader. They can save your tail.
There are... you can use command points to give out a special order. There are some special orders that are really good and game-breaking.
It doesn't take a genius to see that leveling up your soldiers is the best way to beef up your squad. The soldiers will get stronger, and you just might unlock new potentials and orders. All that just from me working you sorry bums into the dirt. I just hope you maggots are ready for a real workout the next time I see you here.
Yeah, exactly. And we have the R&D, research and development.
Welcome to R&D, man. What can I do you for? Wait, I know that insignia. You're Lieutenant Gunther, aren't you? I knew it! Man, I've heard about you. That evacuation at Brule was just... wow! Protecting a tiny life in the middle of all that slaughter? Man, man! Oh, Lieutenant, you're good people. You get all my respect and then some, bro.
What's going on, Leon? I could hear you from clear across the hangar.
Oh, Casey, check it out! It's Lieutenant Gunther! He's the man, man!
Sorry about him, Lieutenant. He's like this all the time, I'm afraid. But where are my manners? I'm Priest Cherney. I'm training here as a mechanic.
Oh, and I'm Leon Schmidt. But just call me Leon, bro. I'm your boy.
So, Lieutenant Gunther, what brings you down to R&D today? We do work here on weapons development, making upgraded weapons and equipment.
And that includes rifles and machine guns. We can even soup up your tank. Of course, research expenses aren't cheap.
With rifles and other firearms, we'll mass produce new models as they're developed. You won't have to worry about making enough for your squad. We'll outfit them.
For tanks, you can upgrade the baseline performance of the body itself, or develop optional parts that you can add on to tweak out its specs.
Right. You can choose which optional parts you want in the tank equipment section. Come in anytime and make adjustments based on the needs of the operation at hand.
So basically, these guys are going to be our upgrades. So we can get an accuracy boost for our rifles on the scouts, which we'll do.
Whew, it's done. This one's perfect, bro.
Because we want our shots to hit. It's probably the more important thing. In fact, I think we'll upgrade all weapons. Also upgrade our armor, which we will do as well. The guns are especially important for the snipers. You do not want them to miss because they only got one shot. Grenades and our tank. Well, we can get the body enhancement, and that's, I think, what we'll do. Now, that's pretty much it for our money, though.
Here you go, bro.
Well, sir, was that... We're working here around the clock to make possible tomorrow what's out of reach. Come again a little later. We'll do our best to...
Yeah, you better come back soon, bro.
Alright, and that's our HQ. We can always go back to it between missions to level up and... develop more weapons. Yeah. I mean, you should be doing skirmishes most of the time to get more money experience. But I think you can streamline as well all the way to the end of the game. Kind of like Final Fantasy Tactics.
How'd your enlistment go? No problems?
I registered as a tank pilot and mechanic. Maintaining and operating the Edelweiss would be my responsibility from now on. I think it's nice that we'll all be on the same squad together.
Oddly convenient as well.
I think so too.
So what are you up to now?
The tank's hangar space is just through here. I was just carrying some ragnite fuel back. It's used to power the tank, and also for the turret-mounted cannon rounds.
I guess I'm just more used to seeing it in street lamps and medical compounds.
Seems like everything is ragnite-powered these days. That stuff is everywhere. Not enough of it for some people, though. It's the source of a lot of conflict.
They say the Empire's invading only to get at all the ragnite in Gallian soil.
Oh, that's right. I had something to give you, Welks.
What's this?
Father's flare gun. It was in the barn, but I thought you might have some use for it.
Another hand-me-down.
I gave it a once-over. It might be old, but it's still serviceable.
I didn't mean... I can't believe I'm a tank operator.
Clean coal.
Thank you for this, Ace.
I'll do a spot check on the Edelweiss now, to make sure it's ready to go at any time. All right, we'll get going for now then. See you later.
Our first stop.
I'll cut to the chase. Here's your mission. The Great Vassal Bridge was just taken by the Empire. It's a key strategic position.
The Great Vassal Bridge?
It's a major drawbridge crossing the canal in Vassal, just outside the capital.
That bridge is a part of the central transit artery, leading into Randgreaves. Our mission is to take it back.
How will we do it?
The Empire has been running a blitz, with their shock troops outrunning their defense. Our 3rd Regiment will retake the bridge before defensive reinforcements can arrive.
Now, Quaint, the militia holding a little strategy meeting of its own. How long were you planning on hiding out in here, Verrat?
My apologies, sir. We'll depart soon.
Whatever. They're just country mice. It's not like they'll be much help.
More help, perhaps, than your army unit that couldn't hold the bridge in the first place.
Oh, snap! You go, girlfriend.
Hey!
Regardless, Vassal remains a critical position. We'll reclaim it immediately.
Well, all good. See that you do.
Who is that?
General Damon, commander of the Central Forces.
Central Forces? That's the army branch the militia was folded into, right?
That's right. They say the general's an aristocrat. He looks down on the common militia.
That doesn't make any sense.
Right. Now that the war's begun, we all need to band together and fight to keep Galia safe. Who cares at this point whether you're in the army or the militia? It's ridiculous.
Gentlemen, let's return to the mission.
Damn the nobles. Revolution when?
We'll begin by taking back the western bank to gain a foothold for reclaiming the bridge. Lieutenant Gunther, I'm assigning Squad 7 to this mission. It's your first maneuver, so be smart.
Yes, Captain.
The other squads are on patrol. Stay sharp and be ready to help take back the bridge. I'm counting on all of you out there. Now move out.
All right. Yeah, so skirmishes basically. Give you experience, give you money. If we're too weak, we'll have to do a few missions. And there are some missions that you can just grind in a single turn with Alicia.
Here are details on the current operation.
Alright, so the mission is pretty simple. Go and take the enemy flag. So they want us to bring scouts and engineers to our right side and have shock troopers on the left. Makes sense because they have less to move. Rosie's on the right side, of course. We've got a Largo here. Shock trooper down here. We'll get a poor sniper down. Don't know if we'll use her, but and we'll put Haynes. Yeah, that's fine. Oh. Not much we can do here. Well, let's put in Claudia then. I'd like to have an engineer near our tank only because she can repair the tank.
Squad 7, move out!
Alright.
Alright, it's our first mission. Let's split into two teams, City and Riverside. I'll lead the Riverside team towards the enemy encampment with the Edelweiss.
Shock Trooper here. Leave the offense to me.
City Team, your job is to guard the base. Be ready for anything, including tanks.
How long you think I've been an anti-tank man? A couple of tanks ain't no sweat.
That's a spirit, Largo. Now, let's move out!
Listen closely. This information could save your life.
Alright, so here's our base camp. Like the game said, we get health regened in the camp. Our ammunition also gets regenerated. So it's a pretty good deal, all in all. We'll bring Rose. Or do we bring Alyssa? Because I know there's a unit in the grass here. Was not the best move, but it worked somehow. Alright, let's see if our sniper... our sniper's garbage!
Leave it all to me.
Please don't let up on the offense!
Have taken the girl sniper. They suck.
Beat Empire.
Beat Empire.
Feel weak.
Don't want to go too far. Now, if I remember well, we're gonna get some, some tanks saying hello.
Ain't no stopping me.
I mean, I could get closer, right? Now there are ace units, like I said, in the game. There's one in the grass. Also, don't move close to a tank. It's a one-way trip to death. So many points.
My turn, okay?
Let's send out Alyssa.
Be ready for their counteroffensive.
Enemy sighted.
Yeah, see, his name is Ty the Immortal. For now.
Let's do this thing.
Ain't no stopping me.
The great
go down.
So when you kill the elite units, you get a little bonus. And, well, yeah, that's, you want to find them in every mission. Well, let's move the tank. Shoot from here? Well, I could probably mortar. Let's see. I can't really see, but I can assume there's something there. Oh, took out the tree. That's fine. Light tank, I can probably take it out, but we can bring our scout here to scout out the rooftop.
okay?
I mean, that's your fault, Alyssa. I hope you die. You deserve every single shot. You deserve every single shot there. Two shots to the head. That's all you had to do.
Use those sandbags when you can.
Alright!
Alright, we gotta go save Alyssa though. So they got two tanks. Well, this will be interesting. Almost got the NG killed. Well, I mean, they're not really that tanky. They're not tanky, the engineer. It's okay. He's still good. Get someone out now that we have we saved Alyssa from dying.
You're done.
So tank busters are pretty good. Pretty good at their job. I can snipe that guy from downtown. Right, Catherine, you have one job. A single headshot. Let's see if our sniper can pull it off. God damn it! Get out of the way. Get out of the way. Okay. Well, it's not great. So we'll just take a shot at the tank. Controls like ass. There we go. I fucking hate this game. I've never had this bad luck. This is insane.
Make sure we control the high ground.
Should have sent the Lancer instead. I mean, I should have had that shot. It was 100%. It's like Mordheim all over again. Is back. Okay, let's take a single shot to their Who are these guys? All right, Catherine, easy shot. Oh, she got it. She actually got it. Send Rosie in to clean up.
Here I come!
Rosie is so good.
Operation complete. We took their base.
Now, if I hadn't lost Alyssa, this would have been a bit quicker, but also if I hadn't missed the tank shot, that would have been a lot quicker as well. And we seize the weapon from the enemy. I mean, she could just stab him. She could have been a spy.
You're the son of the great General Gunther, huh? You look awfully young. How old are you anyway? Must be your first war, huh? What's been the hardest experience so far? Wait, happiest. Funniest. I'd also like to know hobbies, favorite foods, what you do on your days off.
Hey, lady! This is a combat zone. Excuse me, but what are you doing here anyway?
Hey, give me a break, will ya? Scoops are near danger. And I'm near Scoops.
Two Scoops.
That's right. The name's Ellet. I'm GBS Radio's top woman reporter. I smell a story. A good story. And you guys are in.
So, you're a reporter?
Very good. I'm a reporter, yes. I've been assigned to Squad 7 to conduct a series of interviews. Thank you. Now, let's get back to those questions, shall we?
What a stupid question.
Giving interviews? Who does he think he is? Ooh, look at him. Son of some big hero. Please. He's still a schoolboy.
Look at Rosie. She's done all the job. Where's her interview?
No kidding. One little win and he's the new Grand Duke. I hate kids. Whatever. He'll learn soon enough. Only one thing matters out there in the field. That's experience.
I mean, you're just level 2, man. I wouldn't talk shit.
Chapter 4. Operation Cloudburst.
Getting all the tabs. But what I think we'll do is we're going to call it there for tonight. I hope you guys enjoyed it, our new long play, and we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching, everyone.